Welcome back to EdTech School. Sharing knowledge and ideas is key to learning. You can't learn on your own. You're learning ideas from other people, ideas in books, from television, ideas from friends and family, and ideas from your teachers. Because sharing ideas is so important, we need some brainstorming tools to support that. In this video, I'll go over a list of some amazing brainstorm tools. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up or subscribe for more EdTech tips. The first tool is iBrainstorm. Capturing and sharing a student's creative mind is very easy with iBrainstorm. Students can write and add notes to the board. They can even invite up to three fellow students to participate in the brainstorm. Students can start from scratch or they can choose one of the 13 background templates. They can even brainstorm about how to put their football players on the field. The second brainstorm tool is Padlet. Padlet can be used by students and by teachers. With Padlet, you can create an online board that you can share with every student or teacher you want. Just give them the link. Padlet allows you to insert ideas anonymously or with your name. Whoever has the board open on his computer, tablet or smartphone can see what's on it and what everyone is writing. Students can use Padlet when collaborating on a teamwork, and the teacher can use it to do some live brainstorming on a topic in class. Collect your ideas when you find something interesting on the internet that you can use in your lessons. Simply save it to a Padlet board, and students can do the same. Google Docs can also be used as a brainstorming tool. You can work together in the same document at the same time from another device. No more sending files back and forth. No more figuring out which file was the latest. Another huge benefit is that every change is saved automatically, so total disasters are not possible in Google Docs. I've given Google Docs a place in this brainstorming tool list because it's a collaboration tool and is very easy to use when brainstorming from home with other students over an assignment or a new project. Working together has never been so swift and easy. Number four on my list is Poplet. Poplet is perhaps the simplest tool to capture and organize ideas. With a few clicks on your screens, you can make poplets or little squares and add text and images. It's easy to connect to poplets, rearrange them, change their color, and even adjust their shape. Students use Poplet to think and learn visually. Students learn to generate new ideas by capturing facts, thoughts, and images. You can also make mind maps with the mind map widget in BookWidgets, which is our fifth app. Give the students a word or a theme to start from. Now they just have to add words around it. It's pretty easy, as you can see. The last app I want you to learn about is Brainstormer. This app isn't an app that helps you to collaborate on ideas and gives you a solution to brainstorm easily. This app gives you the idea. Use Brainstormer in art lessons and language lessons to give students an idea to start from. The app gives them inspiration to start with. Let them write a story using the Brainstormer app. I'm very curious what the result will be. So these were my top picks for brainstorming apps. I have two more apps in the list on my blog. Feel free to take a look at it. I'll post a link to the blog post in the description below. I hope I've inspired you to teach more from your students' point of view and let them do the work. These apps are just right for that. Thanks for watching. See you next week.